Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a simple blog post banner design just like these inside of one of my favorite design tools called Canva. So if you want to learn how you can create these images, then stick around. What's going on, guys? My name is Tamil and welcome back to my channel. All right, so in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a simple blog post banner design. And I've decided to do this because I have been using this very tool right here called Canva to create all type of awesome images for my blog, for my YouTube channel, thumbnail images, and I've just been creating a ton of different graphic designs using this tool right here. So I decided to show you guys exactly how I create all of my blog post banners right here using this tool. So let me show you how you can get started with this. All right, so what I'm gonna do right here is I'm gonna go right over here to the left corner where it says templates, and I'm gonna click on template, of course, and then I'm gonna go right here and type in blog banners, which is actually pops up right here. That's what you want. You want blog banners. And right here, guys, there are a ton of different banners that you can use as templates to customize. You can change the colors. You can switch out the actual graphic itself. You can really customize these however you want. So if you're afraid of just starting from scratch, then these are all kind of different templates that you can use to start off with to be able to create your blog post banner. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to start from scratch and I'm going to show you how I create images for my blog post. So I'm going to go right over here and create a blank image. And what I tend to do is I oftentimes do start from scratch. So you can have an image already that you want to use for your background. And so I've already uploaded some images. So I'm going to go to uploads right here. I'm going to scroll down so that I can find the image that I'm looking for. This actually is one that goes to my blog post. Actually, I have a blog post already that's for one of these. And so you can actually just click on the image, or you can actually just move the image over like this, and it should fit to scale right there. So once you have that image that you want already, then we can move to adding all of the different fonts and things like that, or any other images that you want. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with adding in my font. So let's go over here to text, and I'm just going to use basic text. So let's type in make, and then I'm actually going to make a duplicate of this. And I'm going to add another one. So we're going to start with make. And then let's make sure that the font is exactly what we want. And I'm going to use a font called Beliza. And obviously, you can use whatever font that you want. You can even incorporate your own font. But I'm going to use Beliza. And I think I want to change the actual size. I'm going to go a little bit smaller. And nope, I think I'm going to go up a little bit more. Actually, I'm just going to make it a little bit bigger because that's too small. And then I'm going to say money, and I'm going to change this to Beliza as well. And I'm going to move this over. I'm going to increase the size to this as well to 121. All right, so now we have this right here, and I might even just have to make this a lot bigger, honestly. Okay, so I'm gonna line that up right here, and I'm gonna also add another text that's gonna say width, and I'm going to change the font to that as well. I have a favorite font that I like, which is called Playlist, and it's one that actually comes with Canva, so you can easily just type it in and find it with no problem. Gonna move this over to the middle. Gonna change the color to white. I think that's gonna stick out a little bit better. And once I do that, I think I'm going to increase it some so that you can be able to see it. a little bit more. And I'm going to actually just tip this just a little bit. Nope, I'm sorry, not that one. I'm gonna tip this one just a little bit so that it tips a little bit. Just gonna move it up right here. And I'm gonna add another one. And this one is actually going to say brand. And I'm going to change the font to this one as well. And this font is going to be the same thing, which is Beliza. I actually like that font. And it's really simple to do. So all I'm really doing is just changing out the fonts on these. Not much different than what you would probably do with other type of designs or tools. And I'm going to make a duplicate of this because I want to be able to add one more. I'm going to use the word collaborations. This actually right here is a post that I have already on my blog. So you can always go over to Mailbox Money Blog and check it out. I'm just using this as an example just to give you something to look at and just to show you what you can do that's very simple. Obviously, all I'm doing is just adding text here. But with this simple design, guys, you can just create any type of, you know, blog banner that you want. And it doesn't really take long to do, just a few minutes, honestly. And so once I have this up right here, this one right here is for a post called Make Money with Brand Collaborations. It really just shows you how you can collaborate with other people and how you can make money doing so. So I'm just going to pull this over a little bit, and this is pretty much it. It's really simple to do. I'm going to move this up some. And now next, what I want to do is I want to go and grab an image, and it's actually this image right here, which is my logo. And I'm going to add the image, and I'm going to put it inside of the coffee cup just to make something like cute and simple. But I'm going to add it right here inside of this coffee mug. And there we go right there. And lastly, I want to actually add the title right here. So I'm going to go back up to text and I'm going to create this text right here. I'm going to just type in the title for this particular post. And it's called The Do's and Don'ts of Brand Collaborations. And I'm going to make this a lot smaller. So I'm just going to pull it in. I don't know if you can see that, but you can see right here where it has this right here. I'm just going to pull it in right here, make it small. And then I'm going to reduce the font all the way down to little of nothing almost. I'm going to keep pulling this in. I'm going to use this right here to tilt it so that it fits correctly or really nice and neat on this right here. Now, lastly, before I finish, I want to change the color right here to make it stand out more. So you can go right up here to the top where it says text color, and you can really find any type of text color that you want. But for this right here, I'm going to use my brand colors because my brand colors are blue, black, and white. And I'm going to change the font. So you can probably see right here where the font is blue. And I'm going to change the font to this one as well and make that one blue. Now, this may seem as if it is small, but the image size is already chosen for you guys because obviously blogs use standard image sizes. So you don't have to worry about coming up with the image size for your blog post. It's already done for you. And of course, if you want to make this bigger to be able to see because this looks a little small, if you go down here to the bottom of the page, you'll see that I have it at 32%. Of course, you can increase the size to this to make it bigger or smaller. And this is how it would actually look. But sometimes I like to keep it a little small. I don't know. I just don't like it too big. So I want to keep it a little bit smaller. But when you get ready to download this image, it's not going to look like that. So this is actually how the image would look once you download it. And to be able to download this image, all you have to do is just go up to the top right here, click download, And then you can choose to save it as a PNG. I don't like to save it as a PNG. I typically save everything as JPEG. And once you save it as JPEG, then you can actually hit the download button and your image would look basically like this. So guys, this is how your image would look once it's downloaded, and you can use that image now on your blog post. So guys, this is a simple blog post design that you can use for your blog. And I use this as a custom design. Of course, you know, you can use a template if you want, to be able to just do that and not have to really worry about coming up with, you know, any type of design, then you can definitely do that. But this is actually how it looks. So guys, I hope you got some value out of this video and I hope that you like it. Also, give me a thumbs up if you like what you heard and let me know if you're using Canva to create any of your blog post images. All right guys, so thanks for watching this video. Leave me a comment down below and let me know how Canva is working for you. All right guys, thanks for watching and I will see you on the next video.